In this video, we will discuss best practices for grounding and cable shielding for electromechanical and linear position sensors. The standard practice for linear position sensor cabling is to use shielded cables. The first decision to make is whether to use cables with individually shielded conductors, shielded twisted pairs, a multiple conductor cable with overall shielding, or some combination of these. For DC in, DC out analog output linear position sensors, such as an LVIT, DC-LVDT, or potentiometer, it is satisfactory to utilize an all shielded cable. For AC in, AC out linear position sensors, such as an AC-LVDT or inductive half-bridge LVDT, the best practice is to use shielded twisted pair conductors, one pair for the primary excitation and another pair for the differentially connected secondaries. Having individually shielded conductors is rarely required for most linear position sensors. Another important choice is whether to use braided shielding or foil wrap shielding with drain wire. Braided shielding has better mechanical properties and is adequate for low to medium frequency applications, but is somewhat harder to work with and is typically a bit more expensive. Foil shielding is typically less expensive than braided, is easier to work with, and is often better for high frequency applications, and for use in locations with strong EMI fields. Linear position sensor circuits often face the issue of ground loops causing unwanted current flow. To eliminate ground loops, maintain a single common ground point. It is strongly recommended not to connect the sensor cable shields or drain wires to the sensor's housing or to separate ground points. Connect the shield's other end to the system's master ground as a Faraday shield. For sensor support instrumentation, only a single wire should be connected to the system's master ground from only one ground terminal on the equipment. Another consideration is cable capacitance, which depends on conductor size and shielding. It is less critical for short cable runs of less than 30 feet, but for lengthy cable runs up to 300 feet maximum, especially with AC-operated sensors like AC-LVDTs, cables with a low capacitance of around 15 picofarads a foot are crucial. They minimize undesired phase shifts between sensor input and output and maintain system frequency response. In summary, grounding and shielding in linear position sensor systems has many facets and nuances. For help finding an ideal solution for your industrial application, contact us now to speak to an experienced application engineer. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and click the bell to turn on notifications. Harold G. Schaevitz Industries. Performance and reliability is our business. Thanks for being on our team.